Elon Musk just changed everything, making things like Sword Art Online possible in real life a lot sooner than we thought. So make sure you completely destroy that like button on your way in, and let's dive right into it. The company Neuralink, which is owned by Elon Musk himself, held their biggest event yet, known as a show and tell, which is supposed to update the public about their brain reading devices. But this time, we got one of the most insane news we ever had. Now, Neuralink's goal is to create a device that can be implemented in the brain to then be used to control a computer with just using your thoughts.
What? What the f***?
And all the way back in 2019, Musk already revealed that the company was testing its device on monkeys, even recently showing a video of one of them playing Pong by just using its brain. But now, Neuralink is finally ready to take it to the next level. So let's break it down. Probably one of the biggest announcements during this event is that they plan to implement these devices into real humans within the next 6 months. And Elon even claimed that he would get the device implemented into his own head in the near future. And during the presentation, he mentioned that the company has submitted most of its paperwork needed for human clinical trials. And although he even hoped to already start these all the way back 2 years ago, knowing that they will actually take place within 6 months feels almost unreal. But Musk took it so much further, especially when he started to talk about what is possible using these neural implants. Because these tiny implants will be capable of both sending and reading signals that are coming from your brain, which is very similar to something we see in .hack and Sword Art Online. But what makes it so special is that Elon Musk said that Neuralink could restore vision even on someone who was born blind. And the company is also confident that the Neuralink device can restore full functionality to severe spinal cord injuries, making it so much more capable than just using it as an input device, and instead letting people with actual medical conditions finally see or walk again, almost sounds close to science fiction. But let's dive a bit deeper into how these chips work. With one of the most important things that Elon Musk directly mentioned is that all the future implants will be upgradable, as he mentioned in the following quote. Upgradability is very important because our first production device will be much like an iPhone 1, and pretty sure you would not want an iPhone 1 stuck in your head if an iPhone 14 is available. So this would make it possible to constantly get a better chipset once technology moves forward. Now, the Neuralink implant itself is known as the N1, with the whole thing itself being about the size of a quarter. But putting it into your brain is no easy task and needs to be done by a very specific and unique surgical robot known as the R1. And during the event, they also showed a live demo that you can see on screen right now, where they implemented a chip onto a dummy. And this directly came with their announcement that they now have their own double operating room, with the plans of the company to eventually establish their own complete clinic. And we also got some insight on the charging of this neural device, because since last year, they improved the battery, which is now also capable of wirelessly charging. And as we can see in the presentation, where monkeys who had these brain implants were charging them wirelessly while getting a nice banana smoothie at the same time. But it gets a bit more complicated once we talk about the Neuralink software, because right now it is only possible to move a cursor using the brain implant. And although the speed and accuracy has been improved, there is still some big ways to go. And at the moment, they are working on a keyboard interface interaction, even showing off a monkey that was typing on a keyboard by just using its brain. But probably one of the most interesting topics was about their upcoming next generation implants, because these chips are not only capable of reading, but also sending signals directly to the brain. And like mentioned before, this could have huge implications in the medical field. And with their first human trials in sight, these developments are gonna take off even faster. Even so, that it might soon be used for the general public, which could mean that you will be able to control your computer or phone by just thinking about it.
Nice.
And although this sounds completely insane, it is very similar to concepts like we see in Sword Art Online, where the main characters use a fulldive nervegear that both read and send signals directly to the brain to experience virtual reality as if it's real life. With the biggest difference that in SAO, the body movement of the players are completely shut down. But besides gaming, this technology absolutely has insane potential. But it also brings some big moral questions, like the whole fact that you would actually need to surgically put a chip inside your own brain. Now, the whole reason that this crazy technology is actually possible is thanks to the big funds that Elon Musk has. But that doesn't mean that he is the only company that tries to achieve this, because we have seen many others, like Meta and Valve, trying to create brain-computer interfaces that integrate into VR headsets. For example, the Gallia headset that was made in collaboration of OpenBCI together with Varjo. This absolutely insane device was capable of reading signals from your brain and then to translate them into commands in virtual reality. But with the best part of all is that it did not require any implants and was built completely inside the VR headset. Compared to Sword Art Online, this headset was not capable of sending signals back to the brain or shutting down the body's motor functions. All it could do was replace your controllers by getting inputs from your thoughts. But that was not the only problem, because it also came in at a ridiculous price point, making it near impossible for any normal consumer. Where in Sword Art Online, the headset could directly stimulate all the senses of the players, almost making it difficult distinguishing reality from the virtual world. But sadly, we do not have a breakthrough yet to figure out how to achieve this without physically going into the brain, and let alone make it accessible for consumers. But of course, there were many other projects working on this, but most of these projects were either highly exclusive behind closed doors or completely abandoned, with the biggest reason being the costs, but also because there is still so much we do not know about the brain, and the only way to actually get to it at the moment is by stimulating it directly with implants. But one of the biggest reasons that Elon Musk hosted this event was to recruit new people, especially reaching out to people that have experience in advanced devices, technologies, or even in a medical field. And this type of recruitment is becoming more common, because even Meta is now putting up an award of $45,000 if people are managing to hack its VR headset. These are mostly done in efforts to harden security of hardware or to recruit new people for that company. But in case of Meta, this is done through a bug bounty program. So if you are very capable of exploiting bugs in VR software, you could actually make a complete living out of it. Not only that, it is almost every single major company that is trying to do this. Thanks to these big awards, they get in contact to one of the most talented people. And to sweeten the deal even further, they also get a chance to fix their own security. And this is exactly what Elon Musk is trying to do, and using the big funds that he has, pushing the limitations of what is possible, and recruiting at the same time one of the most talented people across the world to make technological breakthroughs that before we could only dream of. But that leaves the question, if in the future it would be possible to get one of these implants so that you can control all the electronic devices around you and so much more, would you actually do it? Let me also know that in the comments below. But it does mean, if you want to full dive into the world of Sword Art Online, we will still have to wait a bit longer. But with these massive announcements, it might come a lot sooner than most of us expected. But we had even more crazy VR news, so make sure you don't miss it by clicking on the video you see on screen right now. And of course, stay awesome.